गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डिवीजन लाइकोफाइटा ऑफ टेरिडोफाइटा. डिवीजन लाइकोफाइटा इट इज एन एंशियंट ग्रुप ऑफ द टेरिडोफाइट्स. डिवीजन लाइकोफाइटा कंप्राइजेज द एक्सटिंक्ट एंड लिविंग जनरा. द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स of the plants included in the division Lycophyta are as follows. The plant body is known as the sporophyte. Sporophyte is formed as a result of fusion of sperm and egg after fertilization to form zygote. Zygote develops into sporophyte. It is a diploid structure. So plant body is divided into true roots, true stems and true leaves. तो हम इसमें देखते हैं जो division lycophyta है उसको हम लोग जो true roots है stems और उसमें leaves में हमें उसके अंदर दिखाई देती है. उससे पहले जो plants के divisions हैं जैसे कि हम algae हैं, fungi है, bryophyta है, उनमें हम लोग जो plant body है उसको हम thallus बोलते हैं क्योंकि उसके अंदर ट्रू रूट स्टेम उसको डिफ्रेंशिएट नहीं कर सकते हैं. जो लाइकोफाइटा है उसके रूट्स एंड स्टेम्स डाइकोटमसली ब्रांच्ड. तो जो रूट्स और स्टेम्स होती है वो टू पार्ट्स में डिवाइड होती है आगे जाके, तो इसे हम बोलते हैं डाइकोटमसली ब्रांच. लीव्स आर सिंपल सिंगल अनब्रांच्ड वेस्कुलर बंडल फॉसिल जनरा हैड लीव्स सेवरल फिट लॉन्ग. तो जो लीव्स हैं सिंपल सिंगल अनब्रांच्ड वेस्कुलर बंडल होता है इसके अंदर, और फॉसिल जनरा के अंदर जो लीव्स पाई जाती हैं वो काफी लंबी होती है. लीव ट्रेसेस स्टील के अंदर क्योंकि इसकी लीव्स जो होती है दे आर माइक्रोफिलस सो देर आर नो लीफ गैप्स इन द स्टील ऑफ द स्टेम. लिग्यूल देर इज अ स्ट्रक्चर tongue-like structure present on the adaxial surface of leaf of some genus, some genera of the pteridophytes like Selaginella and Isoetes. This structure is known as ligule. So in division Lycophyta, there are two classes on the basis or on the presence or absence of leaves. The ligule is present in one of the class of the division Lycophyta, while in the other class it is absent. Vascular cylinder is a protostele, but siphonostele have been found in some fossil types and living members. As we know that vascular system in pteridophyte is protostele type, means there is a single core of xylem which is surrounded by phloem, which in turn surrounded by pericycle, endodermis and cortex and epidermis. So this type of stele which is simple is known as protostele. This type of stele were found in the primitive pteridophytes also. So this is known as the primitive stele, but in the siphonostele there is a pith in the center. Pith is surrounded by xylem, core of xylem, phloem, then pericycle, endodermis, cortex and epidermis. So on the basis of presence or absence of pith, we divided this stele two types, protostele and siphonostele. So in some members, siphonosteles have been found in some fossil types and living member. But maximum of the genera have protostelata. Cones are known as sporophylls along with the sporangia are aggregated to form structures called cones or strobilus. So sporophylls in the pteridophyte, the vegetative, there is no difference in the leaves of vegetative leaves and the sporophylls. When you see from the outside, both are looking same. But in the sporophylls, on its upper sides, cones or sporangia are attached. So these leaves are known as the sporophylls. So these sporophylls are aggregated in a compact structure. These structures are known as cones or strobilus. The pteridophytes are in the division Lycophyta. The genera are homosporous or heterosporous. Homosporous means there is only one type of spore in this genera. The spores, the morphological, there is no difference in the structure of the spore. Whereas in the heterosporous spores, there are two types of spores. When we take a look on its morphological features, we will find there the spores are smaller in size and some spores are larger in size. So in a same plant, two types of spores which differ morphologically, a small one is known as microspore and large one is known as the megaspores. Microspore will develop into male gametophyte, while megaspore will develop into female gametophyte. So both types in the division Lycophyta, we will having the genera, both are having homosporous or some are having heterosporous. Secondary growth does not take place in the members of the division Lycophyta except in the isoetes. In isoetes, some secondary thickenings found in the stem classes. On the basis of presence or absence of ligules and on the morphology of spores, there are two classes in the division Lycophyta. These two classes are E-ligulopsida and Ligulopsida. In the E-ligulopsida, all the genera are homosporous. They are having the same type of spores. Leaves are without ligules. Leaves, there is no ligule present on the upper surface of the leaf. In the E-ligulopsida, there is one order, that is Lycopodials, and the families are Protolepidodendraceae and Lycopodiaceae. Whereas in Ligulopsida, the genera included in this class are having heterosporous, two types of spores which differ morphologically in their structure. Leaves are ligulate, and four orders included in this class: Ligulopsida, Lepidodendrales, Pleuromials, Isoetales and Selaginelles. अगर हम बात करते हैं क्लासेस की, दो क्लासेस से इलिग्युलोप्सिडा और लिग्युलोप्सिडा होती है डिवीजन लाइकोफाइटा के अंदर. तो जो इलिग्युलोप्सिडा, उसमें वो स्पोर रखे गए हैं जिसे अब बाहर से देखते हैं तो उनके आकार में हमें कोई भी अंतर दिखाई नहीं देता है. अगर हम क्लास लिग्युलोप्सिडा की बात करते हैं तो उसमें जो स्पोर्स है वो हिट्रोस्पोरस है. अगर हम बाहर से देखते हैं तो हमें कुछ जो स्पोर्स है वो छोटे दिखाई देते हैं आकार में और कुछ बड़े दिखाई देते हैं. तो जो छोटे होते हैं वो कहलाते हैं माइक्रोस्पोर और जो आकार में जो बड़े होते हैं वो कहलाते हैं मेगास्पोर. मेगास्पोर से फीमेल गैमेटोफाइट बनता है और माइक्रोस्पोर से मेल गैमेटोफाइट डेवलप होता है. लीव्स के ऊपर एक जीभ के समान छोटा टंग लाइक स्ट्रक्चर होता है जो कि इसकी बेस पर अटैच होता है, जिसको हम कहते हैं लिग्यूल, जो कि इलिग्युलोप्सिडा में नहीं पाया जाता है और जो लिग्युलोप्सिडा है उनमें वो स्ट्रक्चर पाया जाता है. इलिग्युलोप्सिडा के अंदर सिर्फ एक ही ऑर्डर है लाइकोपोडियल्स और इसके अंदर दो फैमिलीज रखी हैं और जो लिग्युलोप्सिडा है उसके अंदर चार ऑर्डर्स रखे हैं जो है लेपिडोडेंटल्स, प्लूरोमियल्स, आइसोटेल्स और स्लेजिनिलेल्स. ये ऑर्डर लाइकोपोडी उसमें दो फैमिलीज है, प्रोटोलेपिडोडेंड्रेसी एंड लाइकोपोडिएसी. द फॉसिल जनरा इंक्लूडेड इन द फैमिली प्रोटोलेपिडोडेंड्रेसी आर बैराग्वेनथिया, ड्रिपेनोफाइकस, प्रोटोलेपिडोडेंड्रॉन एंड कैल्पोडीजाइलोन. जो लाइकोपोडिएसी फैमिली है उसके अंदर दो लिविंग जनरा हैं, लाइकोपोडियम एंड फिलोग्लोसम एंड फॉसिल जीनस लाइकोपोडाइट्स. तो ये कुछ जो फैमिली प्रोटोलेपिडोडेंड्रेसी, इसके जो कुछ ये फॉसिल प्लांट है, प्रोटोलेपिडोडेंड्रॉन है और ये इसका रिकंस्ट्रक्टेड प्लांट है. जो फॉसिल्स मिले हैं उनको रिकंस्ट्रक्ट करके ये इसका पिक्चर बनाई गई है, जिसको हम कहते जो इसका ये आपको इस तरह से हमें प्रोटोलेपिडो दिखाई देता है. दिस इज बैराग्वेनथिया, दिस इज द लाइकोपोडियम, लिविंग जनरा ऑफ फैमिली लाइकोपोडिएसी. हियर यू कैन सी दैट इट इज अ स्टेम एंड ऑन स्टेम दिस इज अ लीफ. Leaves, these are microphyllous and cones are or strobilous at the apices of these leaves and stem, and these are strobilous. There are two strobilous on this stem. In the class Ligulopsida, there are four orders: lepidodendrils, pleuromials, isoetales and selaginelles. The members of class Ligulopsida all are heterosporous and ligules are present. Order pleuromials, triacic. This order pleuromials, it occurred from triacic to cretaceous period. Two genera included under the order Pleuromials, these are Notoristiana and Pleuromia. So this is the picture of the pteridophyte. Pleuromia, these are fossils from which these pictures are reconstructed. So this is the stem, this is the stem and root, this is cone and cone scale. Order isoetales, in the order isoetales the living genera are isoetes and stylites. These are the leaves of isoetes, these are roots and this is a stem, comb like stem. Microsporangium, here you have a look at the megasporangium. This is comb like stem, these are roots. Order selaginelles, in the order selaginelle there is one family, selaginellaceae. Genera selaginellite is a genera that was, this genera was extinct in the upper occurred in the upper carboniferous period. The order selaginellite is a living genera and this is the picture of the selaginella plant. This is the stem, leaves. There are two types of leaves in the plant selaginella: ventral leaves and large one are known as laterally, smaller on the stem on the dorsal side is known as the dorsal leaf. Apices, on the apices cones are present known as the strobilus. This is a rhizophore which develops from the apical meristem of the this branch, and these are the roots develops from the tip of the rhizophores. These are the adventitious roots. Here you can see the ventral leaves and the dorsal leaves. This is the structure of leaf and this is a midrib. There is only a single midrib is found in the members of the division Lycophyta. There is no branching, and from the leaf you can see here that there is a tongue like structure arise from this leaf. This tongue like structure is known as the ligule. This is the structure of a ligule. Here you can see the body. Ligule, this is ligule, base of the ligule, attached to leaf is ligule pit and glossopodium. And this is a ligule. In the this is a sporophytic plant of Sligenella. There are two types of leaf. Here you can easily see the two types of leaf. This is a dorsal leaf and this is a lateral leaf. Here you can the sporophylls. These are sporophylls. And in these sporophylls, sporangia are attached in the axil surface and they are formed, aggregated to form strobilus. In this is the ALS of cone. Here you can see this is the axis of the cone. This is a sporophyll. This is a microsporangium. Here you can see many microspores inside this microsporangium. And this is a megasporophyll because it bears megasporangium. Inside megasporangium, there are four megaspores. These megaspores are larger in size as compared to these microspores. They are small in size. Microspores develop inside the microsporangium, while megaspores are developed inside the megasporangium. So there are two types of spore, two types of sporangia in the Sligenella. Thank you.